Dupixent is a prescription medicine used to treat adults and children 1 year of age and older with eosinophilic esophagitis, EoE, who weigh at least 33 pounds, 15 kilograms. It is not known if Dupixent is safe and effective in children with EoE under 1 year of age or who weigh less than 33 pounds, 15 kilograms. Do not use if you are allergic to dupilumab or to any of the ingredients in Dupixent. Please see additional important safety information throughout this video and adjacent links for full prescribing information, including patient information. Hey there, I'm Pixie, and I help people learn more about Dupixent, dupilumab. Today, we're taking an inside look at eosinophilic esophagitis, otherwise known as EoE, and how Dupixent works to help reduce symptoms, such as difficulty swallowing. This is Mark. He knows firsthand what it's like to live with this chronic progressive condition. In a second, we'll listen in on a few of the conversations he, his parents, and his healthcare providers have had over the years.
We've tried everything the pediatricians suggested. We've tried to eliminate certain foods, eggs, milk, and wheat, but he's still having trouble eating.
I'm not hungry anymore, Mom, but can I have some more water?
See? He barely ate anything, and he's been sitting there for an hour.
Yeah, he's such a slow eater these days, and he's always cutting his food into really tiny pieces and drinking a lot of water. He says he's okay, but I'm not so sure.
Mark gets a lot of stomach aches, too. The other day, he went to the bathroom after dinner, and it sounded like he was trying to vomit. Something just isn't right.
Something isn't right. Mark's parents and his healthcare providers haven't put their finger on it yet, but his symptoms, difficulty swallowing, abdominal pain, vomiting, and chest pain, are pretty typical for a teen living with EoE. EoE is a relatively newly recognized condition and can be widely underdiagnosed and misdiagnosed. Did you know that EoE symptoms are often confused for food allergies or digestive conditions such as GERD or gastroesophageal reflux disease? But EoE is actually a chronic condition that can damage the esophagus, the tube that connects the throat to the stomach, over time. People with EoE have inflammation in the esophagus, contributing to difficulty swallowing and other symptoms. By the time Mark got to college, his symptoms had gotten significantly worse.
So, Mark, what happened the other night? You were there 1 minute and gone the next.
Yeah, I felt like I had food stuck in my chest. So embarrassing. I just wanted pizza on my birthday, but I couldn't even get the first bite down. I tried drinking a bunch of water to get it down. I even went to the bathroom and tried to bring it up, but it wouldn't budge. My girlfriend eventually had to take me to the ER to have the doctor remove it.
Oh, I'm so sorry that happened to you. You're super careful about what you eat.
I know. I'm glad I got help, but the ER is not a fun place to spend your birthday.
Oh, that sounds awful.
It was. They had to dilate my esophagus after removing the food. I've been doing what my doctor told me to do, taking a PPI or proton pump inhibitor, but it just doesn't seem to be getting any better.
People living with EoE have a chronically inflamed esophagus. Difficulty swallowing? That's a common symptom. And yes, food can literally get stuck in the esophagus before reaching the stomach. Pills like PPIs, slurries formed from steroids, and food elimination diets may provide symptom relief. Dupixent targets an underlying source of inflammation. When you have EoE, overactive immune cells in your esophagus send out too many inflammatory signals. All this excessive signaling leads to more inflammation. Some foods and environmental allergens can then cause a buildup of inflammatory cells, which leads to even more inflammation, difficulty swallowing, also known as dysphagia, and eventually narrowing of the esophagus. By the time he was 20, Mark's symptoms had only gotten worse. Eating solid food had become incredibly difficult for him. After his visit to the ER, Mark's gastroenterologist suspected EoE. They conducted an upper endoscopy and did a biopsy to confirm the diagnosis.
Mark, the biopsy of your esophagus confirms you have EoE. If left uncontrolled, your symptoms will persist.
All this time, the issue has been my esophagus? It is a relief to finally know what's going on. But is there anything I can do about it?
There is no cure for EoE, but there is data that Dupixent reduced eosinophilic inflammation in the esophagus and improved swallowing. It's the first FDA-approved treatment of its kind for EoE. DUPIXENT targets an underlying source of inflammation that contributes to EoE and reduces EoE symptoms. It works by attaching to certain proteins on your immune cells to block some of the inflammatory signals that contribute to EoE. Adding DUPIXENT to your treatment plan may help reduce the inflammation that contributes to EoE, and it was clinically proven to help reduce difficulty swallowing.
The most common side effects in patients with EoE include injection site reactions, upper respiratory tract infections, cold sores in your mouth or on your lips, and joint pain, arthralgia. Suspect you or someone you love 1 year or older may be living with EoE? Don't wait for things to get worse. Talk to an EoE specialist, such as a gastroenterologist or allergist, about DUPIXENT, a breakthrough treatment for EoE. Just like Mark, you or a loved one may finally get the relief you've been looking for. Please stay tuned for additional important safety information.
Important safety information. Do not use if you are allergic to dupilumab or to any of the ingredients in DUPIXENT. Before using DUPIXENT, tell your healthcare provider about all your medical conditions, including if you have a parasitic helminth infection, are scheduled to receive any vaccinations. You should not receive a live vaccine right before and during treatment with DUPIXENT. Are pregnant or plan to become pregnant, it is not known whether DUPIXENT will harm your unborn baby. A pregnancy registry for women who take DUPIXENT during pregnancy collects information about the health of you and your baby. To enroll or get more information, call 1-877-311-8972 or go to https://mothertobaby.org/ongoing-study/DUPIXENT. Are breastfeeding or plan to breastfeed? It is not known whether DUPIXENT passes into your breast milk. Tell your healthcare provider about all the medicines you take, including prescription and over-the-counter medicines, vitamins, and herbal supplements. Especially tell your healthcare provider if you are taking oral, topical, or inhaled corticosteroid medicines, or if you have EoE and asthma and use an asthma medicine. Do not change or stop your other medicines, including corticosteroid medicine or other asthma medicine, without talking to your healthcare provider. This may cause other symptoms that were controlled by those medicines to come back. DUPIXENT can cause serious side effects, including allergic reactions. DUPIXENT can cause allergic reactions, including skin reactions, that can sometimes be severe. Stop using DUPIXENT and tell your healthcare provider or get emergency help right away if you get any of the following signs or symptoms: breathing problems or wheezing, swelling of the face, lips, mouth, tongue, or throat, fainting, dizziness, feeling lightheaded, fast pulse, fever, hives, skin rash, including rash that looks like a bullseye, or painful red or blue bumps under the skin, general ill feeling, itching, swollen lymph nodes, nausea or vomiting, joint pain, or cramps in your stomach area. Joint aches and pain. Some people who use DUPIXENT have had trouble walking or moving due to their joint symptoms, and in some cases needed to be hospitalized. Tell your healthcare provider about any new or worsening joint symptoms. Your healthcare provider may stop DUPIXENT if you develop joint symptoms. The most common side effects in patients with EoE include injection site reactions, upper respiratory tract infections, cold sores in your mouth or on your lips, and joint pain, arthralgia. Tell your healthcare provider if you have any side effect that bothers you or that does not go away. These are not all the possible side effects of DUPIXENT. Call your doctor for medical advice about side effects. You are encouraged to report negative side effects of prescription drugs to the FDA. Visit www.fda.gov/medwatch or call 1-800-FDA-1088. Use DUPIXENT exactly as prescribed by your healthcare provider. It's an injection given under the skin, subcutaneous injection. Your healthcare provider will decide if you or your caregiver can inject DUPIXENT. Do not try to prepare and inject DUPIXENT until you or your caregiver have been trained by your healthcare provider. In children 12 years of age and older, it's recommended DUPIXENT be administered by or under supervision of an adult. In children 1 to less than 12 years of age, DUPIXENT should be given by a caregiver. Please see accompanying full prescribing information, including patient information. Indication. DUPIXENT is a prescription medicine used to treat adults and children 1 year of age and older with eosinophilic esophagitis, EoE, who weigh at least 33 pounds, 15 kilograms. It is not known if DUPIXENT is safe and effective in children with EoE under 1 year of age or who weigh less than 33 pounds, 15 kilograms.